Julian Woodcock this morning from Viking Mines. Julian, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to be speaking, Julian. Your flagship project here, the Canegrass Vanadium asset. Just firstly, give us a bit of background on it.
Yeah, the Canegrass Vanadium Project is located in the Murchison in Western Australia. We acquired rights to get this project at the end of last year. It's got an existing large resource of 79 million tonnes grading 0.64% vanadium pentoxide, as well as a substantial amount of iron and titanium. The project's seen very little work over the past decade or more, and we saw a huge opportunity to develop the area, and especially when we went out and did some initial reconnaissance and due diligence and saw that the amount of outcropping mineralization is substantial.
And you've just completed this fairly comprehensive drill program. Tell us a bit about it, what the objective here was.
Yeah, this drill program has been the culmination of a lot of work we've conducted in the last 6 months. So we went out and did some field mapping, some geophysical surveys, and then planned initially about a 6,000 meter drilling program. The objective of this program was threefold, really. Firstly, we were looking to test the areas immediately within and adjacent to the existing resources. The resources are located along a trend about 9 kilometers, but only encompass a small part, about 25% of that 9 kilometer area. And we wanted to both validate, confirm what we'd seen in the previous resources, as well as test immediate extensions that we saw to the north and south at the fold nose area and to the northeast and southwest at the Kinks area. We also had some historical data in an area we call King South that's outside of the existing resources, which had some seriously good results from the previous drilling completed in the 1980s, but had never been followed up. So really, we undertook some of the first drilling of any substance in about 40 years. With that area, we're looking at new discovery and looking essentially, the primary objective is to delineate a high-grade component of a resource in excess of 30 million tons at about 0.9%. The reason for this is we've seen other companies in the region, Technology Metals and Australian Vanadium, they've both got projects at feasibility study level where they have a reserve at around that 30 million ton mark that shows economic returns. And we believe we can emulate a similar project here, essentially because the ground hasn't been effectively tested.
And so what are the next steps here for the project?
Yeah, well, we've just finished the drilling, as you mentioned. So we've got a lot of work to do to work through all the drill chips and look at the geology, currently consolidating all that information. We put an announcement out recently, a couple of weeks ago, on the first things we saw at the King South prospect, which had a series of substantial thick magnetite intercepts, which are the host of the vanadium. Over the coming 4 or 5 weeks, we'll be getting the assay results through. So we expect to have all the assay results from this drilling by mid-August, say. We have some metallurgical test work that we're running in parallel to determine that we can recover the vanadium. Once we've got all the assay results and that initial metallurgical test work back, we'll be looking to update the mineral resource estimate in the December quarter this year. On the back of that updated resource and the return of the metallurgical test work information, we're expecting to make a decision to move into a scoping study probably in the first quarter 2024.
You mentioned a bit earlier about the likes of Technology Metals and Australian Vanadium. What do you reckon is the investment case when it comes to Viking Mines?
Yeah, well, we're seriously down the curve at this stage in terms of the completed studies on the project, but we've seen very comparable intercepts of the right tenor and grade. So whilst the current resource sits at a lower grade of 0.64%, within that there are some substantially high drill intercepts exceeding 1%. Which we see at those other projects. Now, those two companies have spent the last decade or so advancing their projects, and they've established reserves greater than 30 million tonnes, as I've mentioned below before. And I sincerely believe that we have the opportunity, and investors have the opportunity, to get on board with Viking while our share price is currently trading at about the 1.1 cent mark, which caps the company at about 11 mil. We've got a healthy cash balance at this stage. We ended the last quarter with north of $4 million in the bank, which is fully funding our current activity. And in comparison with the market caps of those companies, that really is the objective and the pathway that we can see investors hopefully seeing some appreciation in the value of the stock.
I suppose, Julian, just away from the vanadium project, you've also got some gold and lithium interests.
Yeah, so we have another project, which is a couple hundred kilometers north of Kalgoorlie. It's called the First Hit Project. It's a high-grade gold asset. It was historically mined in the early 2000s. About 30,000 ounces were mined at a high grade of about 8 grams a ton. That infrastructure, it was an underground mine, remains in place. And we have conducted drilling there before. We've had some high-grade intercepts previously. We've got a reasonable-sized land package there. Interestingly, in that area, we're only about 40 kilometers from Delta Lithium's Mount Ida project, which has defined a quite substantial lithium resource, and they're moving forward with that at a rapid pace. So we're in the district, and we've seen pegmatites on our ground. At this stage, we haven't identified any spodumene, but we have in one of our previous drill holes identified lepidolite, which is another lithium-bearing mineral. So we believe there's some substantial potential in that ground, and we'll be looking to get out there and undertake some more work later this year.
Good to speak, Julian. Thanks for your time.
Thanks very much, Andrew.